What's going on, guys, and welcome back to the channel. Now, I know I've been gone for a little while, but I've been taking care of some personal stuff. I am a veteran by definition, but I'm still in the Army Reserves, and I've been sort of working on my Army Reserve career. We've been doing things around the house. You know, Ashley and I are fresh homeowners, and I had some work to do with, you know, some car stuff I had to do in California, so I was working on that, so that took up a lot of time. But that doesn't mean that I haven't been busy collecting parts, mainly for the Daytona. The Challenger, for the most part, I just really need seat time in it. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what I've been collecting for the Daytona and what we're gonna do today.
All right, so right here on my makeshift table, I've got the rest of the Daytona body kit. So these are all the pieces in the rear. This is for the side of the bed. This piece is for this side of the bumper right there. Exhaust cut out, the other side of the bed, and of course the very rear of the bumper that goes right there. Over here, I've got the side skirts, the official Daytona side skirts. I got rid of those tubular ones that I bought the truck with. Now, these were black, and I give a shout out to my boy Ezekiel Quinones. I'll put his Instagram right here so you guys can see. I hit him up and I was like, hey man, you always seem to have the right Daytona parts. If you've got some side steps, hit me up. In like less than 48 hours, he had them. I went to Dallas, I picked them up just to turn and burn. Over here, I got the DJM lowering control arms to drop the front of the ram 3 inches. I have the, let's see what I got over here. This is the C-notch kit for the Daytona for the bed from when we lower it. So I'm still waiting on the flip kit. Got my power stop track day pads for that beast right there. So drop kit for that for the front, C-notch kit, side steps, body kit. And over here I have a spare 5.7 Hemi engine, and the heads are behind my lawnmower right there. And I got this from my friend Wyatt in California while I was out there. His Instagram is at @6smallblockbro. I'll put it right here. He's got a sweet 67 Barracuda that he's got another Hemi like this that he's building for it. So a pro touring autocross car. So yeah, shout out to Wyatt for this. Appreciate it, man. That's going to be the start of a fresh new build for the Daytona. So anyways, I'm going to start by putting these pieces together and then putting them on the back of the Ram. All right, so that was the easy part because I've already taken those off. Really needed this rear bumper next, so I'm just gonna get a new one. You can go ahead and get it painted. But yeah, that was the easy part. Everything's already there, really easy to install. Now I'm gonna go ahead and do these smaller side bed pieces. And I don't think I have any hardware. I got the metal plates that sandwich between them. I don't have any hardware, so I might have to go get some.
All right, guys, so rather than boring you with watching me install the body panels and the side skirts and everything, I decided to just dive right in and get everything done. There was some hardware that I was missing, so I ended up just getting creative. I used riv nuts and some hardware that I had, and everything came out great. So yeah, let's just take a look at the truck. It's finally starting to look like a Daytona. Now, when I got the truck, it wasn't really good shape to begin with. It was just missing a couple pieces, but we're getting to the point where we can start doing some serious work to it. So let's check it out. All right, guys, there it is. She's finally looking like a Daytona. Right off the bat, you guys know I did the Daytona side steps. I got these from my friend, like I told you earlier. I got these from Joker or Street Terror Performance on YouTube, this piece right there. And I already had this piece all the way back. One thing I did recently as well is I replaced the tail lamps. I thought, you know, the grill covers were neat and everything, but I think this gives the truck a much cleaner look rather than having those grills on there. I contemplated getting some smoked ones, but I just went with the classic red look. I think it fits the era of this truck very well. And then again, side piece, side skirt. Other thing I changed recently was the headlights. You guys know that. I did the grill and I did some LED fog lights, and it got sort of like a smoked housing, so it matches like the black headlamp. Let me back up a hair here. So yeah, it kind of matches. So yeah, really like that. Truck's coming out great. As you guys saw, I had the DJM front lower control arms. I'm gonna go ahead and get a bump steer kit, so when we do the front lower control arms, we can replace that as well. And got the C-notch for the rear, and of course we're just waiting for the rear flip kit. All right, for my local guys, you guys always want to know where I get my stuff painted. I got this stuff painted at a local automotive shop. When I do things like this, I like to support my local businesses, and I supported a shop called Hometown Kyle Automotive, and I'll give you guys a link in the description below if you want to check them out for general maintenance or just getting some paint work done like I did. I've been driving by that place for like the last 5 years, and they have like this this sign that says we do automotive painting. So I was like, you know what? Let me go in there and give it a try, and they did a great job, so I'm really happy. Silver's a really hard color to match, and they did a great job. Well, all right, guys, there you have it. That is the update with the Daytona. I got those side steps and the rest of the body kit on, starting to look like a real Daytona. Got some new LEDs, got some new lights. The next body piece that I definitely need to get is this rear bumper. It is looking hella whooped. Right there, you can see. It's got dings and dents. So I'm just gonna get a whole new one, take it to Hometown Kyle, and have them paint that up. But that's where we're at right now. Got her all cleaned up, looking nice. Give you guys a little walk around here. All right, guys, that about wraps up today's video. I know we're short, kind of straight to the point. I have done some things to the Challenger. I'm just kind of waiting to show you guys what I've done. Other than that, like I said earlier in today's video, just seat time and sort of finding more events to go to. Some events coming up in the next couple of weeks are the High Performance Expo at Circuit of the Americas. It's also where they're going to be hosting Optima Ultimate Street Car Invitational. There's gonna be drifting, like Von Gittin Jr., some other sort of celebrity appearances. So that's in a couple of weeks. It's sort of replacing SEMA this year since SEMA was canceled. So pretty excited to go to that. Got a couple of autocross events with Vet Motorsports, supporting our veterans, of course. And that should about wrap up the year for me pretty much. And then the following year, 2021, which is pretty much what we're preparing for and trying to get this truck ready for, is We Are Mopar 2021. Of course, dialing the Challenger for that, getting this truck show ready, and yeah, just getting ready to have a good time. So if you guys like these videos, you know what to do. Hit that like button, leave a comment below, and subscribe. Until next time, guys, peace out.